Hello everyone and welcome. In today's video, I'll go over an Holy DK Arena playstyle and comps in BFA. The footage we'll be using today is from Cervantes, one of the best DKs in the world. This video will also contain updated talents, Azerite traits and stats, so you can create pressure for your team with the right talent choices. The best comps for an Holy DK are THG, DHDK and DK Boomy. DHDK has a lot of sustained pressure and a ton of defensive cooldowns to rotate with Darkness, defensive dispel from the DH and a lot of cleave damage while keeping up pressure. THG is an aggressive melee cleave with a lot of sustained and burst damage. This comp also has a lot of defensive cooldowns to rotate and can quickly score a kill in the opener. Or play defensive and survive until late dampening to eventually win the game. DK Boomy has a lot of burst damage every 3 minutes by bringing a boomkin. Every incarnation from the boomkin will put out a lot of pressure on the enemy team. This comp also has a lot more CC than THG or DHDK, but has less sustained damage. However, boomkins can peel very well for their team and are very tanky, so this comp can easily survive till late dampening. For your talents, your standard build will look like this. Some talents can be swapped depending on what comp you face. For example, All Will Surf can be swapped out for Clawing Shadows instead when fighting a mage, and you know the mage will be the kill target. Since you won't be able to connect onto the mage too much, Clawing Shadows allows you to do damage from ranged and keep up pressure. Death Pact can be swapped out for Wrathwalk if you know you will need the extra mobility, for example when facing a mage. Keep in mind that when specking out of Death Pact, you lose some of your survivability and might have to be more careful for swaps during the game. Pestilence can be swapped out for Defile when facing a melee cleave. When players stand in your Defile, the size grows every second and your Scourge Strike and Clawing Shadows also hit players close to the kill target, which is perfect to cleave down melee cleaves. Unholy Frenzy allows you to put out more sustained damage, since a short cooldown means you can burst more often. Summoned Gargoyle can be used instead of Unholy Frenzy, since it gives you more burst damage but decreases your sustained damage, since you can't burst as often. As a Unholy DK, you should always play with Gladiator's Medallion, since you can rotate your trinket with your team, both defensively and offensively. For your PvP talents, there's one talent which should be played in most situations, which is Necrotic Strike. Necrotic Strike deals a small amount of damage and converts one festering wound into a healing absorb onto the target. The only time it's not worth playing with Necrotic Strike is when playing the Clawing Shadows talent, since you won't be able to reach your target for the majority of the game, which makes Necrotic Strike useless. Decomposing Aura is a good pick versus targets that you will have a lot of uptime on, which means melee cleaves or casters like Warlocks and Shadow Priest. Necrotic Aura is simply an 8% damage increase for you and your partners and can be used versus most teams. This talent should always be played when you have a caster on your team. Anti-magic zones should be used versus comps that have a caster on their team with a lot of burst, for example boomkins or mages. Anti-magic zone gives you another cooldown to rotate with your team and is up for a fairly long time, allowing your team to recover or stay offensive during enemy setups. Dark Simulacrum can be used versus spell cleaves to steal CC like Polymorph, Fear and Cyclone, or to copy defensive cooldowns like Pain Suppression, Ice Block or Divine Shield. Dark Simulacrum has a lot of potential and can be used to copy strong CC to win the game or copy strong defensive cooldowns during burst windows to save the game. Versus melee cleaves, the best PvP talents are Decomposing Aura, Necrotic Aura and Necrotic Strike. Versus spell cleaves, the best PvP talents are Anti-Magic Zone, Dark Simulacrum and Necrotic Aura. Dark Simulacrum can then be swapped out for Necrotic Strike if you're not playing with Clawing Shadows. Additionally, if you don't feel comfortable with playing Dark Simulacrum, Unholy Mutation can be played instead for some extra damage. For your Azerite traits, your best trait is Festamite, which should be stacked 3 times if possible. If you're not able to get 3 Festamite traits, Battlefield Focus is another good trait since it also works for your team. If you find yourself dying a lot, a defensive Azerite trait like Azerite Veins or Azerite Fortification are both good picks. If you're unable to get the Festamite traits, any trait that increases your secondary stats is a good pick for Unholy, to increase your sustained pressure. Examples of traits like these are Swirling Sands, Lightborn Infusion and Retaliatory Fury. Your stat priority is Haste and Versatility. Critical Strike and Mastery have equal value, so try to get as much Haste and Versatility as you can. As a Unholy DK, you focus on setting up kill potentials, stopping CC, peeling and stun change to create pressure or peel for your team. The playstyle goals for Unholy DK are create pressure, kite, rotate cooldowns, peel and utilize Death Grip. These playstyle goals apply to nearly every comp and applying them will help improve your gameplay as Unholy DK. Create pressure. Unholy sustained damage comes from their dots and wounds, so your first goal is to start creating pressure. At the start of the game, it's important to get your dots rolling and build up festering wounds as fast as possible. Jumping into the start of a game, we can see the DK instantly rushes in and starts dotting up the enemy team with Outbreak to get Virillion Plague rolling. At the same time, festering wounds should be stacked as soon as possible to start creating pressure. Most DK comps rely on stunning multiple targets at once to cleave a team down. Your grip is vital in this since you can grip targets into a stun from your team, which creates a lot of pressure. Another way to create pressure for your team is by swapping onto a healer when they use the big cooldown to help their teammates survive. For example, Blessing of Sacrifice from Paladin, Pain Suppression from Priest, or Iron Bark from Druid. By swapping onto the enemy healer when a big cooldown has been forced, you can stop the enemy healer from topping their teammate and maybe even open up a swap window if you force another cooldown from the enemy healer. Kite. DK has fairly weak mobility and takes a lot of damage when they get trained. To make up for this, they have one of the strongest slows in the game, which is Chains of Ice. Since Chains of Ice slows the target by 70%, it makes it a lot easier to kite and avoid damage when facing a melee cleave. Chains of Ice has a lot of potential and should be kept up on all targets for the majority of the game. For example, if you grip a target behind the pillar and the enemy healer is slowed, it could easily force a ton of cooldowns or even a kill. When facing a spell cleave, it will be a lot harder to avoid damage and you have to use the pillar to your advantage to avoid damage. Jumping into the next clip, we can see how you can hug the pillar and avoid damage while your partners slow the enemy team. When your healer gets out of CC, he can then top you again. While avoiding damage at the pillar, you can grip a target to you and stun them to try and force cooldowns from the enemy team, which is a great way to turn around the pressure. Rotate cooldowns. Unholy DK has a lot of defensive cooldowns like Anti-Magic Shell, Icebound Fortitude, Death Pact, and Anti-Magic Zone. Rotating cooldowns with your team is key to staying offensive and avoids overlapping them, which can easily put you behind in a game very quickly. Jumping into the next clip, we can see how you can use your Anti-Magic Shell defensively and to stay offensive at the same time. The Shaman starts casting Hex, and since Anti-Magic Shell makes you immune to magical CC, the DK can stay offensive while staying stable on health. Jumping into the next clip, we can see how Icebound Fortitude can allow you to stay offensive while your healer sits through CC, allowing you to keep up pressure while being immune to stuns. Anti-Magic Zone can be used to counter big offensive cooldowns like Incarnation, Icy Veins, or Avenging Wrath from Red Paladins. In the following clip, we can hear how one of the top teams on the ladder rotates cooldowns and avoids overlapping them by using clear instructions on cooldown management. Let's jump into the clip and see what happens.
Can I see Wings? I'm gonna insta Urden you. Urden there, stay in Urden or die.
I shelled an Urethran. Who are we killing now?
Good communication with your team can help you to avoid overlapping cooldowns. Agree with your team on how you will handle using cooldowns to avoid overlapping them. Peel. When your team gets pressured instead, it's important to peel for your team with grips, slows, and stuns. Jumping into the next clip, we can see the Hunter lands a trap on the Shaman and the Priest moves in for a fear. You can use your Death Grip to peel and grip the Priest away from your healer before he lands the fear, allowing your team to recover. In the next clip, we can see the DK is under a lot of pressure and by using Asphyxiate to peel, you can allow your team to recover. Jumping into the next clip, we can see how to use your Pet Kick and Stun to peel or stop CC on your team. The Shaman starts casting Hex and gets kicked by the DK Pet, which allows the DK to keep up pressure. Unholy DK doesn't have a lot of tools to peel for their partners, but simply gripping away an enemy player during a swap or keeping up Chains of Ice for the majority of the game can be enough to peel for your team. Utilize Death Grip. Death Grip has a lot of potential since it can be used both defensively and offensively. As said before, Death Grip can be used to grip away targets while under pressure to stop CC or break up swaps. The most common use for using Death Grip is to grip the kill target back to connect damage. But Death Grip has so much more potential than just gripping the kill target back to you. For example, you can grip the enemy healer into the kill target to help your partners land a double stun. Another way to use Death Grip is to grip targets line of sight from the team to do a setup. Jumping into the next clip, we can see how Death Grip can be used to grip a target line of sight from the team while stunning them, allowing you to create pressure for your team. Jumping into the last clip, we can see how gripping a target line of sight can easily win you the game. The rogue has no trinket available and is already on low health, and he dies behind the pillar away from his team. By utilizing your death grip and gripping target's line of sight from their team, you can force a ton of cooldowns or trinkets, or even score a kill, and easily turn the game around. That's gonna be it for this guide, guys. Please leave a plus skill if you enjoyed it, and let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll see you next time.